What's up, guys? In this vid, I'll be going over the This Week at Bungie post for January 17th of 2019 and just all of the new news that is going to be coming in Destiny 2 Black Armory. First up, the franchise director, Luke Smith, basically goes over the whole Activision and Destiny situation. They want to thank Activision and all their other studios, Vicarious Visions, High Moon Studios, stuff like that. But they also talked about Black Armory in the future. So first up, they say, in Black Armory, we set the power requirement for the first forge too high, and that meant it wasn't a great chance to jump into some of the new content. We want to find the line between new content that many players can play and aspirational content for players to progress toward. We're exploring improvements to catch-up mechanics for players in upcoming seasons. They even say for the long term, Bungie is committed to Destiny. We created the universe and we hold its future entirely in our hands. The vast majority of the team is hard at work envisioning future experiences, enemies, and ways to play the Guardian you've been building since 2014. We're going to keep doing that. The next section goes over the next update, which is 2.1.4. This is going to be the up the damage for weapons and super abilities. So we're going to be getting improvements to those. So there's three things that they're basically going to be going over, three goals that they wanted to do. So first up, buff underutilized weapon archetypes, adjust hot button weapons in PvP, including Telesto and Wave Splitter, and avoid PvP adjustments that will negatively affect PvE like experiences, basically. Now, I remember last week, or it was either 2 or 3 weeks ago, they talked about all the super changes that they're going to be going over. There's a lot of super changes, like the six-shot golem gun. Every time you kill somebody, you actually get a shot back. So that's going to be like super overpowered. That's just one example, but there's plenty of other things in there. But in this one, they're specifically going to be going over the weapons. So first up, auto rifles in general. Damage increase for rapid fire, adaptive, and high impact archetypes. We find that auto rifles are a little unforgiving for the ranges they ask you to occupy in the world with special weapons, and as a result, we're increasing the damage to offset the higher risk. Okay, that makes sense. I actually did a review over some of the they don't even go over the precision frame archetype. I think the precision frame archetype is weaker than the ones they just mentioned, but still, having those improved is going to be cool. Next, scout rifles. Damage increase for lightweight and rapid fire families, as well as an increase to all scout rifles in PvE. That's good. I think scout rifles are pretty underutilized there. Scout rifles are always going to be on the lower end of damage due to the safety that their range affords you, but the difference currently between them and other primary weapons is too drastic. As a result, we're reducing the size of the gap. Okay, I like that. I mean, I really don't see a lot of scout rifles, especially in PvP. It's always either hand cannons, pulse rifles, or shotguns. And having scout rifles back would be pretty good. I have a few good gold rolls I'd like to test out, just for funsies. But yeah, I'm glad with these. I'm pretty pleased with the update that's going to be coming. Going over sniper rifles, increase the damage of the rapid fire archetype to be able to kill in 2 body shots. Thank you, because I remember I was playing with the Supremacy, and I shot a guy twice in the body. I had a lot of ammo. Like, don't think of me as a bad person or anything like that. I just had a lot of ammo, and I probably missed his head. But still, like, he didn't die. And I was like, I need a third one? This is crazy. But although snipers are still finding success, we believe that allowing you to clean up a kill easier with a sniper rifle will allow the sniper to have that success at more ranges and in more situations. Going over some exotics, the Legend of Acrius. We actually haven't heard of this one in a long time. There really hasn't been a lot, but increased the damage and bumped out the range slightly. As time moves on, things tend to trend upward in terms of power, and in the post-Forsaken world, Acrius simply didn't have the output to match other heavy weapon exotics. Okay, I like that. Going over Telesto, this is one of the hot button weapons because its damage is way too high for its archetype. But going over PvP, damage brought down to match the standard fusion rifle charge rate, thank you. Optics, which is the zoom, was also increased to match fusion rifles with long range scopes. Telesto has become fairly notorious in the Crucible for its effectiveness, even in some cases getting accidental multi-kills due to how high damaging the explosions were. To combat these, we reduced its PvP damage to match its charge rate. This brought up an issue where doing so was significantly hurting the usability of the weapons, so the optics were buffed in return. In general, you should find it an effective weapon, and it won't be quite as generous as it was before. To be honest, I'm pretty pleased with that change. I saw footage, it was True Vanguard, and it was a clip on Twitter where a guy literally, it was on the Citadel, it was like that new Dreaming City map for PvP. He shot Telesto literally halfway across the map, like from A flag to B flag, and killed him. That's insane. That should not happen. Just, I understand, like, they're more projectiles than bolts, but still, like, the spread should have been way bigger than that. All right, Going over trace rifles, increase the minimum amount of ammo you could receive from special ammo boxes. Trace rifles had a pretty rough time keeping ammo reserves in the Crucible, and it doesn't have access to scavenger perks. You should have more success using it more often in the Crucible now, and the changes also affect PvE bricks. Okay. Reduce the strength of Wave Splitter in PvP. After the ammo changes noted above, Wave Splitter had its one weakness removed, so we've opted to bring it in line with the other trace rifles before this patch hit the public. They go on to say weapon tuning is a process. Like, obviously you're not going to be able to figure out everything in just one patch, but they do want to talk about some trace rifle damage in PvE, some machine gun damage adjust, shotgun adjust, and taking a holistic look at the heavy slot options and how much of an impact it has on loadout choices in PvE content. We're always looking at what's currently in use and what isn't in use, as having more choices is always better than being locked into a narrow band. These changes are currently planned to land on July 29th, so 2.1.4 is going to be coming then. This next session is going to be going over the Black Armor experience, and we have some cool changes coming up. So first up, ballistic logs will no longer be removed at reset. Thank you. I just like that, you know. Stack limit for ballistic logs is increased to 5 per character, so if you don't want to pick up any of the weapons for a week, you can just hold on to them, which is pretty cool. So weapon frames carried across reset now refund into the following. So gold frames refunded 1 ballistic log at the end of the week. Silver frames refunded 3 modulus reports. Any instance of a radiant matrix will be removed on weekly reset. That kind of sucks. That just means you have to earn it again. Well, I guess that makes sense if you're going to be getting rid of the frame, so I get it. Players should stop experiencing the issue where frames are missing from Ada's inventory on a week-to-week basis. Players may still only purchase up to 2 gold frames per week. Keep that in mind. All right, drop rate for Black Armory lore increase from 10 to 20%. Thank you. I only have 2 Black Armory pages. And you actually now have to get a successful forge ignition for the chance of it to drop. You can't just farm it like other people did, so probably should have farmed it when I had the chance, but that's okay. Quest set that requires players to defeat a high-value target on Nessus no longer requires a player to land the final blow. Thank you. I got lucky. I got super lucky when that happened. But module supports and ballistic logs will now go to the Postmaster if lost. Capped on module supports still at 15 per account. Forge emblems will be awarded when completing a forge, no longer require that specific bounty. Next section is called Clubhouse Renovations. Essentially, if you're someone who is in the forums constantly, there's going to be an improvement in the forums. Just a heads up, they're going to be adding some new stuff. They're going to be actually condensing like Destiny 2 related posts, eliminating subforums that weren't frequently used, etc. So right now, this is what you can expect on January 22nd when you visit the Bungie forum. So there's going to be Destiny 2. Under that, there's going to be feedback, gameplay, rewards, and lore. Then there's going to be the section Destiny 1, Clan Recruitment, Companion, which under that is iOS, Android, and Web. And then you have the Help, which is all current player support subforums, and then you have the off topic for Destiny. If you want to check out any bugs or issues that are currently being solved or have been solved, you can go check it out on the TWAB this week. It's under basically what would be their report, like resolved issues, goes over 2.1.4 and how that's going to fix it and some other triumphs and I say weapon issues. And then obviously you can go check out those movies of the week. They look pretty cool. But to finish up, they actually talk about what happened on January 11th. That is when Niobe Labs was solved. That's pretty cool. And they say, world first, the Destiny community. While Fireteam executed the plan, we wanted to highlight that this was achieved by more than just 3 Guardians. We thank everyone in the community who lent their troubleshooting skills to help crack this code. Many shouts out to Raid Secrets were made because they ended up figuring it out. But we also must acknowledge those who engaged with each other via social media, whether you're on the forums, tweeting, texting, or submitting your theories to stream chats. Thank you for taking part in this experience. So that seems to be it for the TWAB this week. Now that we're at the end of the video, there's 3 things I want to tell you guys. So number 1, my clan, the D1 Fire Team, is looking for active players in the Destiny community. Our members play all sorts of activities from casual PvE and PvP to the endgame content, like any of the raids, Shattered Throne, stuff like that. If you're actively playing Destiny 2 and want the benefits of a bigger clan, the link to join is below. We're multi-platform, so we have Xbox, PS4, and PC players. All you have to do is request to join, and myself or one of the admins will approve you. Number 2, if you'd like to know how to support me, there's a link below that says best way to support me. That'll take you to a 4-minute video form. Go check that out. That'd be awesome. But if you don't want to do that, you can always like this video, subscribe to the channel, share this video, and all that like content creator good jazz if you want to do that. Third thing, Discord. We have a link to the Discord below. Just a heads up, we're looking for anyone with moderator experience to potentially kind of run the Discord. It's not like super huge or anything like that, but for myself, I'm more of a player versus being a manager, you know? So I really don't know a lot about that stuff, but if you are someone who can be a moderator, awesome. Just let me know. I know for myself, I'm on Xbox, but if any of you guys would like to talk to me or chat to me, Discord is going to be the best way to do that. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. We'll catch you next time.